Hey guys, this is Doug Stokes. I'm going to shoot this video because I've had a lot of people ask me about this or ask me this question. When I put my big dog in my trailer, there's my big dog, and it's inside my trailer. I have a 7x14 enclosed trailer. It will fit in a 6x12 because I've done it. But anyway, down here on my where the tongue goes in on the big dog, I actually have just a pin, and the hook for the cable fits right in there, just by coincidence. I don't know why, but anyway, it does. It fits perfect, and then I hook that down in between that, and that keeps it in there. Now, when I'm traveling, I actually keep the cable tight, as you can see right here. And the other thing that I did is I had to take the cable apart, so what I did is put some tape here so that the fray won't cut you, hopefully. But over here in this corner, I have my battery tender, which is charger and a maintainer both, and then I have a battery right here. This is just a regular old lawnmower battery for riding lawnmower. It's actually I can't see what kind of amps it is. 340 starting amps is what it is. 340. You get it at Walmart. I mean, it's not like an expensive thing. And then here I have my winch, and I got the winch. This is actually a 2500, and I got it at Harbor Freight. And all I did is I've got a bolt going through the floor here and a bolt going through the floor back there, and that's what holds the winch in. And but I did take some of the cable off, and it only has enough cable to go out the end of the to the end of the trailer. That way I don't have a bunch of excess cable. It's not needed. But what it does is that battery tender keeps that battery charged, and then I always have power. And the battery tender is actually plugged into a 110 plug, which is right there. Because my trailer is actually wired for 110, and it goes around and around, and it comes out here, and then I actually plug it in on the outside. I'll walk out there and show y'all that, but I just wanted to show you how I get my cart inside the trailer, because some people are stronger than others, and I'm old, so I try to get things that'll work better for me. I'm gonna walk out here and show y'all where the power actually comes from. I have a plug here, which is a male plug, and it plugs in here, and it goes over to the plug right here. Okay, that's where it plugs in. And then on the other side, I actually have a 110 plug on the outside. And this has actually come in handy, because if I have to have external lights or plug a drill in to work or whatever, I have power on the outside of the trailer. And when I'm traveling, I just take this extension cord right here and I plug it into the generator, which will sit right there. And then I have power on the trailer at all times. The other thing, I have a refrigerator and a freezer in the trailer. So that's why I keep it under power all the time. Y'all have a good one. This is Doug's Dogs, and y'all know we're good.